إمام الحافظ بن حجر الأسقلاني رحمه الله تعالى another حافظ of حديث وتين the title of أمير المؤمنين in حديث in his time. The أمير المؤمنين in حديث in his time and a great Imam of the madhab of Imam الشافعي رحمه الله تعالى. He wrote a book called تبيين العجب بما ورد في فضل رجب, expressing the amazement on that which is reported regarding the virtue of Rajab. That is that everything that is reported regarding the virtue of Rajab and its actions, that these are all fabrications and weak ahadith. All fabrications and weak ahadith. And he said there is nothing found, there is nothing reported specifying the fasting of the month of Rajab, or specifying the fasting of any part of it, any part of it, or making any special salah in it. None of this is reported authentically from Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. None of it. He said, "Walakin ishtahara anna ba'd ahl al-'ilm yatasamahuna fi al-hadith," yani التي في الأحاديث التي فيها فضائل وإن كان فيها ضعف. He said, however, it is known that some of the people of knowledge were lenient and gave concession for the hadith regarding the virtues of actions, even if it has a weakness in it. Even if it has a weakness in it. This is the concession that they run around with when they come with fabricated and weak ahadith. And they don't mention that the ulama have also mentioned that the hadith must not be shadid al-da'f. It must not be very weak. And there can be a slight weakness in it. But Imam Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani says what must be added to this. وينبغي أن يشترط مع ذلك أن يعتقد الفاعل أن هذا الحديث ضعيف. He said, and what must be added to this condition is that the one who does this action must believe and know that the hadith is ضعيف. So if you do an action which is found in a weak hadith, the virtue of this particular action, you have to know that your action is not based upon this hadith, because this hadith is weak. The doer must know this. He says, وَأَلَّا يُشْهَرَ بِذَلِكَ, and that he does not become known by this. It must not become known from him that this is the action of Sheikh Fulan, or Sheikh Fulan caused to acting upon this hadith and the likes of it. So that the jahil and the army, that the layman and the ignorant person does not see him and think his actions to be based on an authentic sunnah, so that they do not follow him. They do not follow him in it. So even the person of knowledge who finds this weak hadith and he wants to act upon it for the virtue, he must know it is weak and he must act on it by himself. And he's not allowed to make this widespread and known to the people. And if he mentions it, he must mention that the hadith is da'if. He must mention that it is a weak hadith. So we see that what is done by calling people to these innovations based upon these weak and fabricated ahadith, it is against the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And it is against the madhab of Imam al-Shafi'i rahimahullah ta'ala and its usul and its foundations. And it's against the manhaj, the methodology and the way of our Salaf al-Salih. It's against the methodology of the Salaf al-Salih to act upon that which is not confirmed from Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Look at the action of Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu when Abu Musa al-Ash'ari came and knocked at his door. And after knocking 3 times he left, because he knows from the sunnah that al-istidhan is thrice.